We want to solve 2 cosine squared x minus sine x equals 1 on the interval from 0 to 2 pi, closed on 0 and open on 2 pi. So it includes 0 radians and it does not include 2 pi radians. This equation is a little bit more challenging than previous examples because there are 2 trig functions, first of all, and then one of the trig functions is squared and one's not, and none of the terms have common factors. But we can perform a substitution for cosine squared x so we can have an equation that only contains the sine function. Remember, cosine squared x plus sine squared x is equal to 1. So if we subtract sine squared x on both sides, we can replace cosine squared x with 1 minus sine squared x. So let's go ahead and do that. We're going to have 2 times the quantity 1 minus sine squared x minus sine x equals 1. Now let's go ahead and clear the parentheses by distributing. So we'll have 2 minus 2 sine squared x minus sine x equals 1. Now we can see from this equation it's in quadratic form, so we're going to go ahead and set this equal to 0 and see if it's factorable. So we'll subtract 1 on both sides. We'll end up with 2 sine squared x minus sine x. We subtract 1, we'll have plus 1 equals 0. Now whenever we try to factor something, we always want to have the leading coefficient positive. So let's go ahead and factor out a negative or a negative 1. So we'd have 2 sine squared x plus sine x minus 1 equals 0. And now we'll go ahead and factor 2 sine squared x plus sine x minus 1. The factors of 2 sine squared x would be 2 sine x and sine x. And we know these second positions must come from the factors of negative 1 so that the inner product and outer product have a sum of positive sine x. So if we put a plus 1 here, we're going to have 2 sine x. And then if we put a negative 1 here, we'll have a negative sine x, and that sum is a positive sine x. And this product must equal 0. So the solutions will occur when 2 sine x minus 1 equals 0, or when sine x plus 1 equals 0. Well, if we solve this equation for sine x, we're going to have sine x equals add 1 divided by 2, that's 1 half. And here we'll just subtract 1, so we'll have sine x equal to negative 1. So at this point we can use a unit circle to determine which angles have these sine function values. Remember, on the unit circle sine theta is equal to y, so we'll look for y coordinates of 1 half and negative 1. Well, the y coordinate is positive in the first and second quadrants, so let's look for a y coordinate of 1 half in those two quadrants. We have it here as well as here. So this tells us that the terminal sides of the angles that have a sine function of 1 half would be here and here. So on the given interval we would have x equals pi over 6 and x equals 5 pi over 6. And then sine x is equal to negative 1 here. So this would be the terminal side of the angles that have a sine function value of negative 1. And this angle would be 3 pi over 2 radians in the given interval. So here are the 3 solutions to the given trig equation for the specified interval.